let me move to a subject that has a great impact on the health and welfare of our communities, and that is crime. And we've seen some reversals by some of your colleagues who are Republicans about putting a restriction on prescription medications,
right,
and making pseudoephedrine prescription only. We've seen other states do it. Do you favor that in Tennessee?
I do think we have to do something, and meth is such a huge issue. It's really a worse issue in this part of the state. I mean, kind of following the I-75 corridor up, we have a problem everywhere, but it's worse through here. We are looking at different ways that we can limit that without overly restricting people who really do need pseudoephedrine for their, you know, their own personal health uses.
So you're not to a prescription only yet?
No, we're not. We will have our administration, either the governor's office or the safety department and health department, will come with a recommendation of what we want to do this year.
Well, and I assume, Governor, that there's been discussions that as serious as the meth problem is in our state, it is lapped, so to speak, by the issues with prescription,
right,
pills. And what is your office and or the legislature, to the extent that you might know, doing about those issues?
Well, we put some new legislation in place last year where the doctor has to check the database every time, and I can't remember, drawing a blank on the name of what the database is right now, every time they prescribe. So that's step one. Step two, we're working a lot harder on the health education issues. You go to any children's hospital emergency room around the state, you'll see how bad the problem is.
We've got to take another break. We'll be back with the governor of the state of Tennessee right after this.